Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Yes, I do.
How do you believe in God, young man?
I ask you a question.
How do you believe in God, young man?
What color is Christ?
How do you believe in God?
Because for too long, you blacks and Latinos been taught by this man. He can walk out with a stringy goat like here, and you automatically think that he is Jesus Christ. You are the devil since you got in our conversation. Since you got in the conversation, I never said you had to leave. I never said you had to leave. I never said you had to leave. But what we're going to teach is the truth of this Bible so you devils can get out of the head of our people. Where you at?
Revelations chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revealing of Christ. Unlike you, you devil. Be quiet. We're not speaking to you. Go walk down the street and go teach your people those lies. Come on.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Who on this planet is the only people that have woolly hair? You blacks. You black men and black women for the lion Edomite. Come on.
As white as snow.
Why? Because his hair was fully white like that man's hair right there. Read it again. Read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Why? Because Christ drank wine. Come on.
And his feet like unto fine bread.
I got a question for you. Is your feet the same color as your face? That's what a devil would do. A devil would never answer the question. You just splurt out stuff. Okay, let's be men. Let's be men. Is your feet the same color as your face? Huh? You're a damn devil. You're a liar. Look at that. Remember when we read in Psalms 58:3 that the wicked is estranged from birth, from the womb. Go back. Go hold that. Go back to Psalms 58:3. Because you can't even talk to them. They don't want you to learn the truth, so they try to talk over us. But we're built for this. Come on.
Psalms chapter 58, verse 3. The wicked are estranged from the womb.
Malachi 1:4 told you that the Edomites are the wicked nation. Come on.
They go astray as soon as they be born.
So the Bible says the so-called white man goes astray soon as he's born. I know. Come on.
Speaking lies.
He does what?
Speaking lies.
From the cradle to the grave. He speaketh lies. Come on.
Their poison is like the poison of a serpent.
Yeah, what they teach you is poisonous to your salvation. Come on.
They are like the deaf adder that stopped in his ear.
A deaf adder, a snake, don't got eardrums. He don't want to hear nothing that the Bible got to say. He'll just go on and on. But I'll answer the question for Mr. Edomite. Yes, their feet are the same color as the rest of their body, unless they was walking through mud. You don't love me, you hate me. Okay, you got the blood of Jesus in you? Then I'm gonna ask you a question, blood of Jesus, man. Your feet, are they the same color as the rest of your body? You're a damn liar. Read it again.
Psalms 58:3. The wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies. Their poison is like the poison of a serpent. They are like the deaf adder that stop at his ear.
So they don't want to hear the truth. Go back to Revelations 1:14. 1:15. Because What you don't understand, the white man knows you don't know the Bible.
I've never met a white man.
You know Christianity. I bet you're Native American, ain't you?
I bet you you're high on something.
Because they be looking just like that, talk about I'm Cherokee Indian. Shut your mouth. So for you to walk around and say that you're the Jew of the Bible, you're a damn liar.
He's way down there. I don't think he's listening.
Give me 2 and 9. Read this. Let's see what the Bible says about those who claim they are Jews.
Revelation chapter 2, verse 9. I know thy works and tribulations.
What's the works and tribulations? Your poverty that you're going through. Your oppression, black man. This is an important conversation. Come on.
And poverty. But thou art rich.
Why are you rich? Because you have the rights to the kingdom if you repent. You have the glory and the promises that God offers you if you do his will. Come on.
And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
What is blasphemy? It's the highest form of lying. That say they are Jews. Say that they're a part of the covenant. Say that they get the same promises that you get. What about them?
And are not. But
they are not.
But are the synagogue of Satan.
The assembly of the devil. Yeah, because the average person thinks we're picking on you when they first walk up. But you're the one who butted in our conversation. You're the one. So when the other white man said, we're the Jews, he calls himself piggybacking on it. But let's find out about the fake Jews. Read it again.
I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich.
You Israelites, you real Israelites, you're rich. Why? Because God is your God. Come on.
And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews.
Those that is in control of what you read, if not what you read, but what you learn. They teach you blasphemy. But I'm going to show you something. Because a lot of people think, oh, we're just hateful. Hey, bro, don't worry about him. Give me that. Hold that. Give me Joel 2 and 27. So we're going to put a nail in his coffin real fast. We're going to put a nail in his coffin real fast. Because one thing about us, we know the Bible. We know what we're talking about. Yeah, 2 and 27. Let me go.
Read 28
first.
Joel chapter 2, verse 28.
Because this is what Peter was paraphrasing in Acts chapter 2. Come on.
And it shall come to pass afterward. Then I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old man shall dream dreams. Your young man shall see visions.
Look at him repeating what we're reading, right? But it's an uppercut, because he don't read the verse above. But it speaks about you dreaming dreams, having visions, coming back to teach your people who they are according to the Bible, because that's a history that's been erased. You don't, but we don't have the same God.
Verse 27. And ye shall know.
No, go 28.
28. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old man shall dream dreams. Your young man shall see visions.
Now watch this. I'm going to say this. Because they'll take that verse, because that's what the pastor do in the church. Take a verse, isolate it, and make a doctrine out of it. That's verse what? What verse is that?
28.
So we're going to read 27 and see the read it in context. Read it in context. Come on.
Verse 27. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and I am the Lord your God, and none else.
What?
And I am the Lord your God, and none else.
The Bible says God is the God of Israel. And none else. Nobody can stake the claim of your God. You worship the damn devil. This is who you worship. The God that loves everybody. But you're not going to find that in the Bible. So let's see what Christ says. Because God said, I'm the God of Israel and none else. Let's see what Christ said. Did it change? Did it change? Your Judas is scared. Because Edom is the evil twin brother of Jacob.
I'm John.
You're the devil.
No, I'm not a devil.
Matthew 15 and 24.
I hope you're not, but I can't.
Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said,
this is Christ speaking. Come on.
No,
I am not sent. Christ is not sent. But unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So
Christ said, I'm not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. In the book of Joel, God said he's the God of Israel and none else. What should be the most important question that somebody should ask right now?
Why don't you ask it yourself?
You don't want to answer nothing I ask you, so why are you even talking to me? Why don't you ignore me then?
You think I'm the devil?
You ignore me when I ask you a question.
I hate evil.
You are evil.
No, I'm not.
The Bible says you're
evil.
I'm
going to
ask you, who's this man?
You need washed
who's this
by
man?
The blood of Christ.
Who's this man?
You need washed by the
see
blood.
See what I mean? Who's this man?
Tell him to ask.
Tell him to ask. Tell him to ask the question. I mean, answer the question. He won't. Because you're estranged from both. Soon as you're born, you speak lies. Where you at? Read it again.
Matthew 15:24. But he answered and said, I am not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
So Christ said in himself, I'm not sent, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
That's right.
That's it. That is it. He's finished. There's nothing else you can say.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.